We're following some breaking news at this hour. A young girl stabbed and burned in front of her home. It happened in the Greater Pines subdivision in Claremont early this morning. 15-year-old Calvin James Haskell was arrested soon after the crime. He's behind bars charged with attempted murder. West News' Jeff Lennox is live outside of ORMC where the 14-year-old girl is recovering this evening. Jeff?
Yeah, Jim, the 14-year-old victim, the young girl in this case, recovering at ORMC this evening from both her burn and stab wounds in this case. In the meantime, the investigation continues into why this happened with the Lake County Sheriff's Office.
Driving into work early Wednesday morning, neighbors in the Greater Pines subdivision of Claremont watched crime scene tape and squad cars flood their neighborhood. It's not a common sight to them.
About five different crime scene units, tape everywhere, police officers, everything, you name it, they were here. Yeah, it was scary.
You know, to wake up in this neighborhood and see that going on is more than shocking. It's very disturbing.
Investigators with Lake County Sheriff say around 5:30 in the morning, a 14-year-old girl left her home to meet up with 15-year-old Calva James Haskell. When the two met up, the sheriff's office says that's when Haskell stabbed the girl several times and set her on fire after spraying her with a flammable liquid. Paramedics rushed the girl to ORMC.
You know, you can just hope and pray that she's okay and she gets better quickly.
Detectives arrested Haskell at the scene, charging him with attempted first-degree murder. Kids in the neighborhood say the two at one time dated. While detectives try to find out the motive behind this crime, neighbors are still letting all of this sink in.
It really makes you take a little bit of a reality check and try to find out where you are. And
I have a young girl, too, you know, that's going to be that age one day. It's scary.
The suspect in this case, the 15-year-old, is behind bars at a juvenile detention center in Ocala. His first appearance is set for tomorrow morning, and the state attorney's office will decide whether he will be tried as an adult. Reporting live outside ORMC near downtown Orlando.